Okay, we're going to show them.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're good. Okay. You're fine. No, you're okay.
I'll just smile.
Okay, good.
I just really hope that we're all warmed up. No injuries on my watch, okay? I'm never going to be allowed to coach again. Okay, so from here, I think what we're going to do is we're going to spread out, grab our hammers, and I'm going to walk you through the wine itself.
The stretchy tape. Is that the one you need?
I'm going to use electric.
Okay.
Thanks. Keep our right. right elbow kind of up when we wind, which is going to feel really weird. You're going to feel like a weird stretch in your shoulder. Everything's fine, I promise. So just keep moving it this way. So it, for that, like what it's going to do is it's going to prevent you from like reaching back. So you can really just move the hammer in front of you. So you're not going to be moving like the hammer like you. So you're not like reaching back. You don't want to like stretch or pull and all in front of you. Good.
So you're thinking about right elbow up the whole time, even in front of you, the elbow stays up.
I mean here, you're like in front of you, you're basically focusing on half a little bit, just like come out. For me, what's really helpful kind of stays sort of balanced. What Mona, okay, what Coach Mona figured out is that I personally need to really exaggerate everything, like in my head, to do it like right, in a sense. So, for me, I'm always a little more this way when I wind, but if that's not like the most natural thing for you to do, or if it's not comfortable, if you're not achieving what you're trying to do, and you don't need to do that, that's just something I found really works for me. So, elbow up, wind, and you're gonna see. And the hammer's gonna bring you in, and we're gonna come to that in a little bit. So for now, let us pick up our hammers.
Hopefully my phone hasn't been the same.
Are you recording it right now?
up. One concept I'm kind of playing with right now that I have a hard time with, too, I kind of wanted to think of anybody on the left side. So when you're whining, I think about like saying, you know, support the finish, and you can pick me up, and if you want to do that, I kind of want to go out a little bit.
I want to get to first turn too, I promise.
Okay.
But wind is super important. I was just,
agreed.
We're just talking about, for me, I think it's one of, if not the most important part of the show. It's going to set up your highest pro. It's going to get the rhythm going. It is going to basically set up the rest of your throat. So that's kind of the one that's so important.
Throw it out as far left as it can get, or are you not even thinking about throwing left like on the
Sorry. So, one day, for me, right. My right arm is up. It's coming out to the left, but notice that even with my hand established, I'm still allowing the ball to move as far as it can go before it starts to come back around my body. So that's what I'm talking about here, is letting the ball be free, it's movement, but you're still in control. All of the way it's moving around you. Does that make sense? Yeah. Don't think about keeping the ball up. You guys sort of see what I mean when I say, like, right arm. It's not like you're bracing against the throw necessarily, but you're allowing the ball to have that fluid transition kind of around you. So you're not forcing it, but you're also allowing it to come out. I like that.
For show, they try to ratchet it back. And it,
I think getting them to free gloves that I got, so we can see about the ones that next transitioning to the turn and then starting to do like this. I got some discus back. I got a lot of key issues, exciting. I got some talented people, a little bit of everything. The only thing is just getting them to honestly think it, understanding it's a competition. So like,
dude, I was just talking to like that mom.
Are you still getting hookups on Nelco? Not on the Nelco. I mean, they're just, I mean,
I've been actually trying to
pin that right about that concept was going to pass
the
I guess I was getting, you know, like, what is it, the first part is like, yes, it's just like, you see, or whatever, so whatever you have, that's essentially the same. It comes down to, as long as I trust, I've just been telling people,
if
you don't like it, just give it back to me, I'll refund your money. And it's like, they've been moving, so. I had to go to Coin based on your recommendation.
Yeah, like I said, it's low right now.
Well, that's the other thing. I didn't realize it's not good to have an exchange. Why is that? It's like that coin is easy. I just need to get down to 12 and a half.
Yeah. Oh, one, two.
Was that what it was?
I'm curious. It's zero, two, isn't it? I want you guys to tell me what you're thinking about when you're doing these wands. How it's different.
Hit the left side early. Start right, left back, start right, left back. 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 Back.
like story time, which is when it's why I was saying the leaning back before could be really dangerous. So 2018, end of my freshman year here, I was leaning back a lot in my lines when I was throwing. And at first, it was fine. I thought I was getting more leverage on the ball. What ends up happening, I actually blew out my ab. So I was putting so much force on coming back here to try and catch it earlier that I actually ended up basically pulling my entire ab. My oblique was like steel. And it took like weeks to recover. Which is why Coach Mo and I established this line a lot more after that, so that I wasn't reaching back, but I was allowing the ball to basically be more free and come in while I was still strong. So that's like one of the reasons why, again, this line is so important, is because it allows that ball movement, it allows that freedom, and it allows you to have more control, so you're not like looking back, you're not risking any sort of injury or anything. So I'm really glad you actually brought that up, because that's something that I had to learn as well. And like changed my wine, but in the best way possible. So now you can kind of see like letting it come here restricts it a lot. And the thing is like you're not just right here in your throw.
Right? Very
like
good. Stay
throw,
on that left, okay?
The hammer is all the way around.
Down and locked off.
It's free. It's like moving.
Right,
you are still in
it's
going to
feel kind
of
crazy.
But being in control doesn't mean it has to be like locked in sort of here.
That's how I know you're
especially
left.
On the line.
Nice.
So
easy.
I'm also glad that you
get
brought
over
that
the
up.
Head. Look.
Okay. Good points. Glad we're all working on
there's still a couple though.
Okay. So,
we're
doing interesting things over there. Huh. Okay. So, okay. So, what I want us to do now is I want us to do our normal wine, okay? Or what we've been working on in our wine. But all I want you to do. So, what I want you to do is sort of work on the transition of going from a wine to your first turn, but we're not doing a full first turn, and I'll sort of show you what I mean. So, remember when Coach Mo was saying, like, push like right to left, like right hand into your left hand? So, what I want what, like all of us to do is do our normal wine, and then I want you to sort of bring it out to the left. Bring it out to the left in a more stable fashion than I just did. And sort of establish that ball moving out to the left. Because you're going to feel it in your whole throw. So, for me, my first wine, the ball is already moving very far away from the rest of my body. But I'm not trying to, like, so, like, when I do it, when I transition, I try to go so that the ball is already, again, established on the left side. So it basically carries me through the rest of that throw. But I want you guys to feel how that ball, like, pulls you out to the left. And then after, we're going to work on getting through that first turn. But right now, I like that we're working on bits and pieces so we can kind of, like, feel that transition, kind of, like, smooth it out and see how everything works together, like, in puzzle pieces. So please be careful. But do your normal wine. Again. Bring it out, but don't do a full first turn.
Just go like this pretty much. And like stop it.
So almost like in that first turn, you know how like when you come out of the wine or any turn, you know how you feel the ball come out or maybe like the ball like moves out to the left and it like turns you, like the ball's gonna turn you in the throw. You're trying to let the ball come in. So I want you to bring the ball into the point where it almost starts to turn.
Actually, I'll take it back. We're on the left hand.
Maybe we could just go at different times.
Yeah, we can just go and see. Slightly over that left, break that left side action.
Everything I said before. it's so important. You know, to really establish that right at the beginning. So when you bring it in, your ball, like your hammer, is already, again, imitating your turn. There's no sort of transition needed. It's already bringing you in. Does that make sense?
They drop their hands, right?
So at what point, so you talked about working more specific stuff, or what did you think in your head to turn off basically your brain so it's more automated versus like mechanical or like parts of the throw?
Honestly, for me, I kind of stopped thinking in my throw once I had taken so many throws that I chased that I didn't sort of need to get in a way. Like, that really comes in time. And with learning how your body works, and what things are going to feel like, and what the camera's going to feel like everything's a learning curve. And so for me, it was basically just time. But right at the beginning, when I was trying to do it, it was more like, I feel like at this point, we know what the show is going to be like. We know what we're trying to do. And so, just sort of let it happen.
You started to feel it versus like basically like.
Yes. Gotcha. Which is why I like saying like feel through your body sounds so weird, but that's honestly the way that I throw and that I've kind of always thrown. Is that you're feeling things out, you're not trying to overthink them, you're not trying to force them, you're not trying to like get into like certain cues or positions. Like it's not going to be that strict when you're actually throwing, and that's what's so important. So,
the only reason why I'm asking is that I work with beginner athletes, and so when I say, hey, like, whatever you're dropping your hip or something like that, they'll focus on it so much that when it comes to competition, it'll be more mechanical versus, like, automated, where I'm trying to switch that to being just more automatic and that's kind of what I have a lot of my better athletes are, because they're starting to work on more specific stuff, it's hard for them to just throw versus this or whatever through the entire thing, right? That's why I was kind of like, what made you click or just not think about, right?
So one of the drills that I promise we will work on actually really helped with that, which is going to be like a wind, one turn, one wind, two turn, one wind, three turn, two wind, two turn, one wind, three turn. Drills are important. We don't do a lot of drills, I will say. They're basically our warm-ups. I will say that right here. Coach Mo and I don't really do this. But I feel like that's a really good starting point to feeling how, or knowing and learning how things are going to feel in the throw, so that when you get to the throw, you're not trying to just like get here and it's like, oh crap, I need to drop my hand. You know? So it's not like, again, you're trying to like force your body into these positions that just aren't natural in the throw and just aren't going to happen like that. So like I was saying before, for me, I need to really exaggerate things. But that also doesn't mean when I'm going, I'm going to try to like, I'm basically trying to not disturb the hammer in order to sort of get me ready. Which means that I'm still trying to break out of old habits. 10 years on, I've been going for 10 years. Still trying to break out of old habits, but one thing that Coach Mo and I have really established is the ball. That's gonna be the most important part of the entire throw. You're working for the hammer. You know, the whole throw is centered around the hammer. Like Coach Mo always says, like it's called the hammer throw, not the U throw, because there's like really all about the ball. Of course. Does anyone have any more questions before we start to do like the whole why? Yes.
Sending the ball out, I think was good, but I think like what she's trying to get at is, because I have some of the same problems too, that I'll drop, like almost like stiff the leg out with the left, rather than just letting it run to the left side.
Interesting. I'm also like, I feel like I've had to work a lot on keeping my axis on my left, so I understand. Almost like you really just have to keep this whole like unit as sort of like, let me just 2 seconds. I'm really gonna try and think about this. I want to make sure I give you like a good explanation and not just like something weird.
You kept your toe and your knee on top of the toe, and that bring the hip underneath the shoulders.
Yeah, I mean that's kind
of so. I think one thing that's really helped for me in like establishing that left side and not like stiffening up or in anything is knowing that, or like collapsing like into the toe. So you do have to keep your posture. That is something that you do have to like really like do in your throw. I still lose my posture on my throw sometimes, especially if I get like too excited on a throw. I will like really try to like get to certain places and Mo's like, what are you doing? Like, that's not what we've been working on. So with that, it really is just... Okay, yes, got it. I knew there was going to be something. Okay, so I think for me, what has been super helpful is always lifting, like, keeping your left, like, bent, of course. That's sort of the obvious answer, which is, like, not straightening it. It's, like, staying bent with your left, but keeping your, like, ass under you here has been really helpful for me. Because then you're, like, then you can, like, you're not trying to, like,
It could help a little bit.
You have to be able to like sit against it, and that in itself comes with this idea of capturing that Mo and I have also tried to sort of like talk about more, but it's not going to be like a forced carry. You're basically just like sitting against the ball, and actually one of my favorite things to do that he has taught me that's helped a ton. We're doing this, so sit. Sit and sit. And that's what's gonna feel like. Which is really weird. But no, so you're still gonna do it like with your heels. It's not like if you're sitting on your toes like when you're doing this exercise, you need to sit back more. You're gonna be staying back into your heels more. Because you need to be, the hammer's gonna try to like throw you out. You need to be able to basically hold your ground and be like, no. So you're like here almost. I can't really get to that position without a hammer. But it helps. And you trust each other. You can like get a partner and try that. Or someone come up to me and we're gonna do this together. It's a trust exercise, but it's one that Coach Mo and I have done for like memories.
Nice.
It's weird.
Oh, man.
And it's going to feel more natural, like, in the actual throw. So, like, don't worry about that. It's going to feel more mechanical right now. We're not really throwing right now. So, right now, yeah, start working on that transition. Establishing that wind, establishing, like, your posture. And move the ball. No, I should do a turn. But move the ball. And then we'll get into, like, a wind turn. Yeah. Do your natural wind. Do your natural wind. Wait, are you asking what I prefer?
Yeah, like which is better?
Oh, sorry. So I've done 3 winds since I was 16. And that for me has helped with setting up the throw better. You can do as many winds as you like. Like, 3 just worked for me. I know that, like, my freshman year watching Maggie, when she's good. Four. She definitely has to be like 4 or 5 or something. But it's all what feels comfortable to you, what's gonna allow you to limitate that, to get the ball moving so that you can like really bring it in from like a strong point and move it through the air. Yeah, you're sending the ball in around you. Okay. I also want to mention it is a learning process. We've already talked about a lot of stuff, and it's all, we all might be very different. When you learn, it might be very similar. It still takes time, and that's why we're here, right? Learning different ways of how to grow. And this specifically is just how I was taught, too.
Okay.
Too much on the right, you can't get on the left.
Yeah. The same thing for him. So if you wind too hard on the right, and you're never transitioning that way to the left, you can't go around the left axis.
I mean,
right, exactly, because you can't get around the left. So the
discosaur is like, wind over here, they're like,
fall in.
Yeah, sure. What's your favorite drill in the world?
He's got some distance chip. Nation. Right. Oh, dude. Oh, two.